in this fight, my friend. Look at that. That is a gigantic force. That is a gigantic force. As you can see, we've pulled this flank all over the place here. It's exactly what we wanted. To break this right flank here, or their left. Oh my goodness, me, look at that. It's an absolute bloodbath, sir. Oh, that's it. Look at that. What a... This artillery here, this fire support has absolutely done its job beautifully here. Gentlemen, move. That mobility has definitely given us the edge here. USA campaign, and this, my friends, where we left it last time, where we are finally taking the fight here to Austria. At last, one of our oldest and most bitterest foes is finally being hit by ourselves here. We're taking the fight to the Austrian Empire here, and at last we're able to really put in some fine troops here. An army group indeed, my friends, is being launched in here, lodged, rammed into this small frontier. This frontier between sort of these two regions here, no more than 10 miles in distance, my friends. We've jammed in well over 10,000 men here in this army group. Of course, you can see here we've got 9,000 here, but in reality, this army here, you can see at the back here, this isn't really taking part in the battle per se. We're using an army group here to sort of batter our way in, to get our foot in the door of this Austrian Empire. We're heading for Hungary. As many of the council said, Mala, head for Hungary. Once you've taken that region, then assess your options. To do that, though, we've got to fight through several layers of Austrian defence here. And this being the first, they have set a sort of, dare I say it, a trap upon the border here. They've set a quite a strong defensive border force here to try and stop us if we moved in. But we're not going to be able to do that, my friends. We've got this very... Because the front we're attacking into, as you can see, the region we've been attacking into is very, very slim here, very, very small here. Because of that, we have managed to pack in 10,000 men, this army group in. Its power is very concentrated in one place, this mailed fist, my friends. The spear, the tip of the spear is strong on this one, it really, really is. And to that end, we're going to kick in the door here, we're going to punch our way through here, this defensive gap here, and we're going to roll up any of the Austrian forces we see here. And if necessary, we will feed in additional forces here, so i.e. this force here will be fed in, but ideally, we're trying to keep our forces along the border here with the Germans here, because as you can see, Germany really is building up quite the strong sort of attacking force here. Oh, they are taking some damage here, as you can see this slightly tattered flag here, but even though the Germans have been given time to sort of replenish their armies, bring them back up to full strength, but we have also done the same. We've managed to dig ourselves in, but we have, dare I say, not neglected, but we haven't really reinforced Europe, or Eastern Europe, should I say, as much as we should have. As many of you said, Mala, be careful that you're not sort of stretching too far in Europe here. We're not going overboard in terms of, you know, we must be prepared if Germany attack us, because once they attack us, they're going to throw absolutely everything at us they can. Also, there was a concern that navies weren't quite up to scratch in terms of how many we have, so we're going to try and increase our naval forces. many of you were saying about some of you were a little unhappy, should I say, about what happened with the Algiers, you know, moving out from Algiers and putting our forces in there. Some, you know, we had some wonderful suggestions about saying maybe hitting Egypt, the Holy Land, you know, Jerusalem, Syria. Those regions should have been hit first to try and draw off Ottoman power, as it were. We're still going to try and do that if possible here. We can't really draw any forces away from Europe, because if Germans declare war on us again, we are going to be absolutely up to our necks in sort of German forces. We really, really are. So we have to keep everything we can on the sort of Eastern Front as strong as we possibly can. But I know that many of you have come up with some wonderful plans. Many of you, you know, I don't want anybody to think that I'm ignoring their plans or their plans aren't being heeded. They really, really are. Of course, when we develop our plans in the past, things do change quite rapidly. You have new enemies arrive or new situations arrive that alter those plans. But please always remember, your plans will always be enacted. Even if you don't see them being enacted straight away, I promise you they will be at some point. All right, you know, we take sort of the major elements of those plans and try and incorporate them in the overall sort of scheme of things. Now, of course, we've also got that the Spanish conquest or the Spanish invasion, which is on the horizon there. It really is looking quite close now. Also, we've had the suggestion we should take Aquetuc and then sort of clear all that sort of raft of Canadian North American forces that are sort of there, should be taken out. So we've got that, those two regions completely cleared under our control, but also to be careful of the Mamelukes as well, because of course, as was rightly pointed out, they wouldn't just declare war with another nation halfway around the world if they didn't already have something in the planning stages, if they didn't have something already brewing in sort of in hindsight here. We could be maybe seeing an invasion force from the Mamelukes, but until that happens, my friends, we carry on with our plans unabated here. And our first task of today, our first task, is to batter our way through this defences here. We've got our foot here on the Austrian neck, and I can absolutely guarantee you we are going to squeeze it hard, believe me. And the first battle is here, my friends, into the forests here. Almost looking to the forest of Hungary here, heading for Budapest, trying to wrestle a grasp of that away from them. That also gives us that sort of, dare I say, that sort of southern flank as well into German forces. We could even intercept German forces moving around behind the German forces, because remember, we've got Vienna as well, just the neighbourhood there of Hungary. So it really is important there we sort of really keep ourselves ready to strike at any time, but also if needs be to withdraw as well. And I might suddenly think, why would you take that out and then withdraw? Because remember, things can alter, situations alter, where if you need those forces to be pulled back, at least we've got them there. But also we can sort of adapt to the circumstances around us if we are able to attack the Germans from behind. If they pull a lot of forces out from Berlin or from Stuttgart or other regions around there, we can then hit that region really hard with the forces we've got in Hungary there. And look at this. Really is a one, oh my wood, that is a huge deployment zone. This is massive, but it doesn't have very many sort of topographical features here we can use. There aren't any sort of hills, there aren't any sort of, you know, there's a slight incline here, but of course that is on the wrong lane. If it was here, if the incline was here, then, oh, that'd be wonderful. As many of you said as well, I haven't been really using the 24 pounders here, the sort of horse guards really. I've been, as many of you said, you may be using it to look good, but not sort of, you know, allying them, you know, sort of as efficient as they could be to really get the maximum efficiency out of them. I completely understand where you're coming from here, my friends. So I've got to be a bit more careful of my deployment of my artillery as well. And also cavalry, when I'm engaging cavalry, not to engage them in diamond formation when you're trying to extract cavalry from a fight, because it can, you know, completely mess up their sort of formation or their ability to pull out without taking casualties. I completely understand that. So we're going to keep them in square formation. We'll charge in diamond formation, then put them into square formation once we want them to move out. I try to take all your suggestions on board, because it really does need, you know, your suggestions have really put us where we are, to be honest with you, right here now. Of course, look at this, we've got a wonderful array here of three heavy cavalry here, cuirassiers. Look at that, magnificent troops there. Now, as you know, the Austrians have taken quite a bit of damage here. Their armies aren't in the rudest of health, but that doesn't mean that we can sort of take our eye off the prize here. We have to maintain our discipline here. We've got the general here, General Holyfield, who's taking this fight here. We've got a good array. We don't have any elite troops, but as you can see, these are combat veterans here. that always plays well. It really does into our hands if we've got those combat veterans, because they're used to the fight. They're not going to buckle under the great strain that is going to come here. Now, ideally, we'd like to defeat the Austrian forces with this singular army here and then use the other two to force their way into the gates of Hungary. Now, what we will do is we lose the howitzers and we'll set them up properly. And I think what we might do then is use the other artillery elsewhere. Let's have a look at our... Now, we've got a slight incline here, but we don't need that for these. So what we will do is we'll set the artillery as close as we can here to the front. Actually, let's get them involved in this fight quite. Let's just move out some of these forces here. So we've got a much better deployment line, as it were. Thank you, gentlemen. Now. And we've also got, last but not least, this 24-pounder here, Horse Guards. Now, as you can see, we've got a pretty good open fire here, but we've got this slight incline here for it. So, with your advice in mind, I think we'll set our artillery, our 24-pounders here. We've actually got... Well, I'll be damned, look at that. Right, let's reset this. Let's do this by the absolute number here, shall we? Let's do this properly. And of course, we've got 134 men there. I have no idea why that is such, but as you can see here, we do have now a good complement of howitzer. But we've also set our guns up here, our 24-pounders, in a much better position, much more efficiently. I hope that meets with approval there. We'll actually keep them separate from the howitzers. Got the cuirassiers. We've got the General Holyfield here. Again, once again, surveying the fight there. Now we're moving in here, so we're going to have to probably move out ourselves, which means we're probably going to have to use some forces here to weed out the Austrians, as it were, bring them into the battle here. Let's first of all establish a firm defensive line. Actually, what we'll do is we'll use some combat veterans to move out. We'll actually have this regiment here as our sort of central vanguard here of our defence. We don't have any elite troops here, but we don't need them at the moment. This is purely a way to batter ourselves into the Austrian defences here. Remember, the Austrian defences are heavily layered. So we have to be able to make sure that once we get in there, we're going to have to hold on here. Because they have a tremendous amount of forces, especially in Venice. But we don't know how many they've got around the other capital regions they've got. We have to be prepared to meet fierce resistance. I think we'll put these gentlemen here. Now, as you can see, the deployment zone does run counterclockwise. So what we might do is just adjust our lines here a little bit. We have put these slightly at odd angles here. Our artillery is angled this way so we can sort of cover the battlefield. As you can see, it does overlap quite significantly this way past ours. That's why we've sort of got them angled that way. We'll have these gentlemen here. This regiment. I know we could probably use the wall here, but it wouldn't really give us that cohesive front. We shall have... Wait a minute. To bring in these gentlemen here as well on the right flank. That's a nice little sort of cropped area there with some walls around it. We can always fall back to that if necessary. A good strong defensive front. I think we'll use four regiments to move out with the cavalry. A gentleman. And the rest we shall use to put in defensive formation here, because we will come under a significant amount of pressure here, because remember, the Austrians do outnumber us, although they have taken a little bit of a beating. We don't underestimate the enemy at all. If we do that, it could spell our doom. They do have artillery themselves, so we've got to be prepared for that. Now we are going to move out quite aggressively. Where's the demarcation line here? Oh, it's way back here. We can actually use this hill here to, for line of sight, using our cavalry to sort of outflank them. And if we can get up on the high ground here, and you know, with the infantry, that would be a wonderful sight. Right, let's begin this fight, my friends. I think everything is arranged as it should be. Yep, let's begin this battle. My goodness me, that's a huge amount of troops there. Oh, good grief. Look at that. We come under a tremendous barrage here. What I'll be... They're already moving forces up here. We're going to come under a terrific barrage here. We really are. Got to get up on this hill here before this infantry here, this Austrian infantry intercepts us. Move it, gentlemen, move! We're using this hill here as sort of a place to sort of hide and camouflage, as it were. It's going to be a real artillery fight here, it really is. But my... Square! Here they come. Hold, lads, hold! There's a general. We've got to break this frontier. We've got to break it. Gentlemen. Get back in square. Get back in square, gentlemen, please. Oh, that's a wonderful barrage. Look at that. Got to break this flank here. We have to break this flank. Let's deal with this artillery here. They've broken, they've had enough already. Oh my goodness me. been absolutely mauled here. Our whole front is buckled here. Our whole front is buckled. The sheer overwhelming numbers here. Gentlemen, this whole flank is going to unravel here. Lads, hold now. Holy smokes, this has been absolutely insane here. We've got to use the cavalry to try and hold here. We're gonna need reinforcements. This has been a much tougher fight than predicted here. We've overestimated our own strength and underestimated the enemy here. Let's use our cavalry the best we can here. We've got to hold here now. The cavalry is what's going to do it. It's going to turn this around for us. It really is. It's finally cracking here. Oh, look at that. What a wonderful sight there. We've held on here by the skin of our teeth. Get that out of there. Let's get them out of there. Mm-hmm. excuse any noise in the background, my friends. There's a lot of, oh goodness me, look at how they've been hit so hard there. On them, lads, onto them. That's much more like it, gentlemen. Get stuck in there. Clear up this mess here. We've just about scraped through here. Wow, that was a tough fight, and that's going to be something that we keep an eye on here, because we really don't want to underestimate the Austrians here, because they've got a tremendous amount of forces here. Mop up these artillery, please, gentlemen, if you would. Oh, excellent, we've got cavalry in here. It's going to do wonders for us here. Oh, they've broken. Measurement of foot's broken. We've absolutely thrown everything we've got into this, is to try and crack this Austrian defence. That's how tough it's going to be here. Looks like moving in and breaking into this Austrian Empire is not going to be as easy as we first thought here. Not by a long stretch. My goodness me, we're losing heavy casualties here. What a fight this has been here. It has been absolutely brutal, sir. Double time, gentlemen. Double time! We've finally cleared this artillery, which has been nothing but a menace to us. Look at that, they destroyed this regiment here that absolutely fought with great valour. Don't give them the chance to come back, lads. Don't give them the chance. Now one of our finest militia units. Where the blazes are they going? Move back, gentlemen, please. We want to try and get as least casualties as possible here. Oh, good grief, this is... as well, right off in the distance here, 24 pounders. Shattered as well. What a fight that was. What a fight. That was extraordinary. That, look at it. Look at the battlefield here. It's absolutely laden with the dead. The Austrians are not going to allow us into Austria, into Hungary, without a brutal fight. Look at it. Look at the camp. Look at it. The battlefield is littered with thousands of dead here. Not sure about a heroic victory. My word, what a fight that was. We lost 2,134 men. Whoa. That was a brutal fight. Oh, look at that 24-pounder. He did a wonderful job there. But we've pushed back this Austrian force here. Waiting for your orders. We're going to have to really move in some additional forces in here if we want this to succeed. Let's win around in battle. Excellent to see. Excellent to see. Now, so we've got these forces here, we can eventually move in. We might even have to move this force in, actually. Yes. Oh my goodness me, that force is taking a real beating. We have to pull this force back and close in the ranks here with these forces here. Ready and waiting for. Ready for order. I think we'll move in with this force here instead. The General Broglie's force will move in. We'll move this force that took the real brunt of that battle there. They'll have to be moved back to be replenished, but we're going to keep moving, we're going to keep pushing on here. Yes, what if we anchor ourselves around Banska here? Now they've got this Star Fort Komom here, but it's Hungary we're aiming for here, but it looks like we're still going to be in for a heck of a fight. How far can we still move here? We can still move in here with good distance. I thought we would just anchor ourselves here in Banska. Oh my goodness me, sir! Can we take this fight? We have the artillery. We've got regiment. What have they got here? They have got a terrific amount of forces moving in here. But this is the fight we might need to take here to actually finally open up the gateway here to Hungary, and indeed to the... Yeah, I think we're going to take this fight, my friends. Is there going to be a fight here we need to take? We've got to draw them out here. If we withdraw, that's going to be a real defeat for us here. But if we can hold this line here, if we can take this fight, we've been intercepted, which means they're going to probably be attacking us pretty vigorously here. But they've got this force, but where will the other forces come from? We're going to have to really dig in deep here. Keep our cavalry back as a defensive force. Use our artillery as best we can. You know, we've got this initial force coming in, but they're going to be swarming over us with these. We've got militia, line infantry almost at full strength, but some of them aren't always at full strength here, but most of them are. Most of these armies have suffered serious attrition, but we don't underestimate. Look at the last fight. But if we can break open this door here into Hungary, by damn, we can find all of these forces here. Look at how many forces they got stationed outside Hungary. That's how much they value Hungary. We cannot allow ourselves here to be pushed aside. We're going in. Let's do this, my friends. Courage, bravery, discipline is what we need here. We have to hold the line here. We've got to beware, though, that we've got those reinforcements coming in. Probably from our... right flank. If we can try and hold back some reinforcements to remember to shift our lines or adjust our lines as we need be, that's what we've got to do. We've got to do this. Oh, it's a bright day as well. We've got some massively deep deployment zone here. Oh my goodness me, that is a massive deployment zone. Absolutely huge. But we're on a slope. As you can see here, we're actually, the whole battlefield slopes downwards away from us. There's a lot between us and the enemy here. Now, we can assume, oh, there it is, the enemy here deployment zone is here. And actually, there is sort of this hill here between us. You've got to come over to get to it. Now, any of these forces could be hidden here at all in this forest. We need to dig in here. Remember, we don't know where the reinforcements, which flank they're going to come from. And to that end, we must be on the firmly under defensive. We've been intercepted, remember. On our way to into Hungary. On our way into the Austrian defences here. The strategic depths of the Austrian defences here. Now, horse guards. Let's get ourselves in proper order here. Let's not do this in a ragtag way here. We have to maintain our discipline. Now, we're not going to be moving out to face or attack them. We're going to sit firm in defensive position here. We have to have a good balance. Regiment of horse. We're going to keep our horse between the two flanks if necessary. We'll keep the cuirassiers on one flank and the regiment of horse, because I'd say the cuirassiers probably have the same sort of punching power as two regiments of horse. And to that end, we must be holding back every possible advantage we can get here. Now, our artillery is going to need clear line of sight, because remember, we've got a 24 pounder here. And as I have, you know, as many of you have told me, and the council have said to me, you must keep your artillery more efficiently stationed, not just using them to sort of look good. And to that end, we're going to look for the best position here. I would say keeping this line of sight for the artillery is absolutely clear, especially for the regiment here of artillery, this 24 pounder here of foot. We need to have clear line of sight. The howitzers not so much, but the artillery yes. So to that end, I think what we'll do is we'll put the 24-foot here in the open. There's no trees, there's nothing blocking its line of sight. We do have shrapnel shot, of course. And then we shall also put the howitzers... gentlemen. Here. Now, shrapnel shot... How far will that get that shrapnel shot here? How deep into their lines? It won't. That'll give us some depth into it. If we go into quick lime is not too bad here at all. So we'll use some quick lime. Now we've got to deploy. Now we have to deploy properly here. We cannot be caught on the hop here at all. So remember, we don't have a massive force attacking us, but it's what's coming in afterwards is where the problem's going to be. So, I think again we'll establish a strong defensive line. We'll use the regiment here. Now, is anything going to hold us here? We've got this cart here, which always seems to be a bit of a problem, and one there as well. So we're going to set our defensive line just to the south of them here. We really are absolutely going full pelt to the Austrians here. We're going to show them, we're going to teach them a lesson here. Let's just straighten that up there, this defense first. Gentlemen, also, many of you said when you're getting charged, next, another excellent recommendation by the council was to use more depth to your ranks to absorb that initial attack, and also to bayonet charge when we do get the other chance to do so as well. on the right here. Another regiment. Now these aren't our most experienced. We can only keep our most experienced regiments for the sort of the extremities of the line. But again, we're going to try and hold back some reserves just to make sure that we're not going to be hit too hard. So quite a veteran unit here, but again, haven't given ourselves much room here to maneuver. Where's the demarcation line? It's here, so we have got a lot of room to move in here if we really... So I think to that end, we might actually move this line up a little bit here. We've got the windmill here. Might do is just readjust it so it's this side of the windmill. I know we've got the windmill in our way, but still. I think we only need to give ourselves some more strategic depth in our defence here so we can manoeuvre much with a bit more clarity, a bit more focus here. Because if we sort of get trapped here behind, we got nowhere to move. There's absolutely no point in having our troops in such a position here. But also we want to be able to move our reserves behind or to the side or whatever they need to be moved to. We have this regiment here. Again, we don't want to add too much depth to the front. It's what's going to come in from behind us here. And again, we're going to keep our cavalry here ready to adapt to whatever comes our way. And also, I think what we will do is we'll just pull these gentlemen into this box here. We're going to form a box. We're going to actually seal off this flank here. I know this might seem a bit extreme, but we've learned from bitter experience that if you don't prepare yourselves well enough, you will find yourself in a lot of trouble. Now, we are going to seal off this flank as well. And actually, look at that. They are actually hidden here. And again, we're going to seal off this flank as well, just in case. Remember, we can adapt depending on what happens here. Now we've managed to pull in some reserves here and also here, which will be used depending on what happens. We've also got our cavalry here, which we are actually probably going to put on the outside of our defensive line here, because it can react much more aggressively. We do have this cavalry here again, which we will put here in this enclave or this small outcrop here of trees, as you can see, just to be able to strike the enemy. But again, our line has been, and we've also got a good complement here of reserves. And of course, we can use the cavalry here to defend in depth, as it were, using that mobility. Let's end the turn here, my friends. Right, behind them. This is where they are. That's where their first batch of... That's where the first batch is coming in from here. Oh, well done, sir. Now, that's a lot of reinforcements. That is a humongous amount. We must maintain control here. We're going to just adapt ourselves here to what's coming in. So in fact, we're going to adapt here. We're going to straighten our lines. Now we do have strength and depth here, because we do have, luckily we've brought ourselves, don't tell me a log is going to stop us from deploying. We've got to watch out from where the rest of their reserves come in from. Gentlemen, please. wonderful. This is a wonderful display here. We're going to hold at a strong defensive line here. Got to keep an eye on where they're coming from. Those are the reinforcements. Remember, they've got 9,000 reinforcements. Barrage going here. Let's not let them set them settle at all here. Now they've got a lot of reinforcements coming through this rear area here. That is a tremendous amount of reinforcements. It really is. They're pouring through here. They really don't want us to reach Hungary. Now where is Hungary? Is it in the background here? It could possibly be in the distance. There it is. No, it's not. That's just woodland over there. I thought we could see Hungary in the distance, but it's not. That's what we're reaching for. These are the planes before that. Actually, could probably move our general lights back here slightly, just a fraction. General Robert Caton here. Again, just absorb it. Oof, they're taking some damage here. Looks like they're trying to move out of firing range here. Looks like they're trying to gear themselves up here for a move, but looks like the reinforcements have stopped here for the moment. What a shot that was, right into them there. Shot there. Are they going to make a move towards us here? Just skim past us there. Can we goad them into some kind of action here? They're establishing quite a firm defensive line here. We've already given them some good pasting here with our artillery. We need to goad them into some kind of action here, otherwise we're going to be sat here for a long time. Where those reinforcements are coming in from. Luckily we've got reinforcements of our own. Thank you. got to go them out of this defensive position, otherwise they're going to be stuck here for a long time. Gentlemen, thank you. They've broken. We might have sacrificed that for no reason whatsoever, but we just need to get them moving here. If it means we've got to go after them, then so be it. They're shattered. We've lost that one there. That's poor judgement on my part. There's like dragoons there. Then it's so be it. Move on this flank here. Then we shall move with them. We shall push on out. So what the blazes is going on here? General Friedland, if you wouldn't mind moving back here, please, sir. Looks like our reinforcements are going to be coming from this direction here. Then we're going to move out ourselves. Gentlemen, please. Looks like they've got a new general. Try and crack one of these flanks open here, or at least pressure them into moving somehow. Are they going to move against us now? Are they going to finally move against us? Oh, look at that. They're taking a real pasting here. Although we are as well. I must admit, we are taking a bit of a beating here. Come on, gentlemen. Move, move now. I know you're tired, gentlemen. I know you're tired. Crushing these dragoons here. gotta capture that hill before the dragoons make it. Come on, get the advantage of the hill here, gentlemen.
Line infantry.
Let's get General Friedland out of here. Oh, look at that, what a wonderful sight there. You fiends, have at you, sir. Got the hill.
Fire!
Fire! Second rank, fire! Third rank, fire! Third rank, fire! Broken. We're absolutely giving them a damn sound thrashing here. They've come back. Don't you break, don't you break, gentlemen. Turn the flank, lads. We're going to be hit pretty hard here. Support this flank here. Now where are those reinforcements coming from? Any reinforcements coming from anywhere here? Look at these fiends here. We're going to pull our cavalry in. Combination here of artillery support and having the high ground here has worked wonders, sir. They got cuirassiers moving in here. Oh my word, now they're retreating. Now they're retreating. that for fire support. Don't cave in, don't cave in, gentlemen. That fire support has been exemplary, sir. What the blazes is going on up here? Don't get outflanked, gentlemen. Don't get outflanked. They've got a tremendous amount of reinforcements coming in here. Hold, gentlemen. Hold your lines. Come on, they've lost a tremendous amount here from this square. Yes, this fire support here has defended this flank wonderfully. Back, lads. Oh, what a wonderful shot there. The artillery is keeping these gentlemen alive here. Teach them a lesson. We'll teach these Austrians a lesson, sir. These two regiments here have fought absolutely wonderfully here. Have they removed from these horses here? No, they haven't. If we get these out of here, and here come more militia, more regiments. Let's get them shattered, please, gentlemen. Shattered, please. What a fight that was. These two regiments here worked absolute wonders here. Come on, tear them down, lads. Tear them down. They're going to give us some problems. Oh, look. look at that, a glancing blow there. They've seen us. What the blazes? Look at that Swiss Mountain Jaeger. We didn't even see them, they were hidden. Let's pick off this unit. Swiss. Picking these Austrians apart bit by bit. Oh, we've got a lot of line infantry moving in here. Pounding them, lads. Ooh, I thought it was a regiment of... Oh, we're mopping them up here, but they've got a huge amount of forces moving in here. A tremendous amount. If we can take care of these 24 pounders, it will be an absolute boon for us. Don't you move, lads, don't you break! To them. Are we seeing this pocket being crushed? In mind that they've got a lot of troops moving in here, reinforcements. Are they going to ignore us? We're going to sit here and we're going to pick them off all day long. They've broken. Oh, what a shot! What a shot! Oh, wait a minute. wonderful, wonderful display, it really is. We have mauled this Austrian force here. They've had enough, but they, my word, they have fought violently here. My goodness me, that's a gigantic amount of forces here. We stood up against Swiss line infantry here. Or the men that have rolled in mud. They've had enough. By damn, they fought, they've had it. They've absolutely just kept this flank afloat here. They really have. Let's get them back on the hill here. Try and hold all this shatter. They've had enough. Oh, look at this. It's a bloodbath, sir. Sending those troops in Austria. Ah, wonderful. Could we build up? No, we can't build up a strategic front here. But we could reinforce this flank and keep that pressure on the flank here. Oh, they've taken an absolute pounding here, but not that many troops. They're still sending troops in here. Looks like they've spotted us, and so be it, so we meet this charge full on. We've just absolutely been pounding at them for ages here. This artillery has been so effective for us, it really has. So many reinforcements in. Don't you dare break. fire on them, please, gentlemen, if you would, please. Send your men, sir. Get out. Get out, gentlemen. It's no good having hand-to-hand fighters here. Artillery lads, and we've got a chance here. We've had enough. We've got more moving in here. They've broken, but they've broken as well. Gentlemen. Ah, they found their courage. What a shot! Let's retreat them. We need more efficient regiments in here. Oh, look at that. This is an absolute joy to see. And yet they still send more in here. Whew, we've taken a fierce pounding from their artillery. Oh, what a fight this has been here. This is magnificent. It really is magnificent. Excellent, now we can crush this flank here. Roll it up. Pouring in here. Oh, we're gonna have some. Look at that. Infantry guard. Oh my goodness me, look at that. What a magnificent sight there. Are we going to crush in this flank? I think we will, gentlemen. I think we will. Then we're going to cut off all these reinforcements. My goodness me, they got a lot of reinforcements coming through here. That is a staggering amount. We've broken them. Send them to battle, sir, and see what happens to your precious army. This regiment has been an absolute thorn in our side here.
Fire! Move!
they're sending everything they can through this gap here. God, they've taken a heck of a pounding here, this out. There's line infantry guards here. General Broly's here as well with his army, or a small detachment of his army. Look at that. More infantry coming through here. Strong here, measuring, guarding over his units here, commanding them. But bring the fire support onto this right flank here. What the place is going on here? No, actually, just keep hammering away at them. Where's our artillery support, lads? Where is it? Oh, there it is. Oh, that was a beautiful shot right across the flank there. Still more come. That's This flag, lads, break. Oh god, the cuirassiers are in here. And that is a absolute bucket load of forces coming in here. Oh, Will Brody has got his forces well disciplined here. Gentlemen, it's going to need your fire support, please. That's more like it. Oh my god, this is non-stop. Brilliant, absolutely wonderful to see there. Actually, I think we might send General Brody himself to dispose of these three pounders. Looks like we've really attracted a hornet's nest here. Taking command. What we can do is just reinforce this line here. And then what we can do is send more troops up to this, what is becoming Hamburger Hill. Get these gentlemen out of here. We don't need these here. We need fighting troops here. We need... General Brody standing strong here. It's wonderful to see. Gentlemen, don't tell me you're just merely strolling. Move, gentlemen, please. and still they come. Let's change our focus here of attack, our angle of attack. Oh my goodness, we've got a lot of enemy forces still in here. Is that the end of it? Is that the end of it? This could be the final push here. Gentlemen, get out, you're no good here if you're just doing melee. Get out! Disengage and attack the artillery. Don't tell me there's more still coming, and there is as well. Wow. Don't let the 24 pounders hit you too hard here. Get some reprieve here for our men on the hill here. Double time, gentlemen. Double time! Why are they facing that way? Why are you facing that way, gentlemen? Square, square! Get out. Get out, gentlemen. You're no good to us here. Bro, he still hasn't moved from his position here. That's the courage of this man here. down the howitzers on them. My goodness me, it hasn't ended even. Gotta clear this hill. Got to clear this hill. Putting Jen and Rody back. He's done his job here. Then again, he wanted to stay with his men. Oh, I don't believe it. The time ran out, my friends. I don't believe it. An hour. So close, but we did so much damage there. Valiant defeat. My goodness me. 5,000 fight. Look at the difference here. We killed 5,100. They lost. We lost 1,160 here. Got 7,000. They got 6,210. That was a tremendous battle here, but we had to take it. We had to take that fight. I know we've got to retreat. That was a heck of a fight. It really was a tremendous fight. But have we broken the back here of these defenders here? Because they are guarding Hungary here tremendously well here. We have to bring in our troops. And this gentleman here is retreated way back here. Good grief, what a fight that was. That was a wondrous fight. We're not going to give up. We are not going to give up. We've had our first foray here into Austrian territory. We know what we're going to face now, which is stiff resistance here. We knew that, but my goodness me, didn't we realize we need more troops to push in here? Absolutely more troops, and we've spent a huge amount of time here on this. But I'm going to end this episode here, my friends. I hope you've enjoyed it. If you'd like to see another episode, then please let me know. I know we've still got a lot of plans with which to still push through. We've got a lot of fighting here involved in here, especially here and against the Ottomans. There's a massive amount of, but we have finally begun to reinforce here and move in the forces that might even allow us here to hold against the Ottomans. Mind you, they do have a tremendous amount of forces here, an absolute, almost overwhelming number of forces. If we can just keep feeding some more armies into this region, who knows, we could wall this off here, but it's going to be incredibly difficult for us to do here. It really is going to be very, very difficult. 24,845. Trade has been hit pretty bad here, especially with Britain, because of course it's been cut off, plus two morale. Well, that was one of our first defeats we've suffered in a long, long time here, but that was only because the time was against us there, but we know now what we're up against here. We're up against a tremendous defence here. But we can break this Austrian defence. If we can crack open this Hungarian nut, as it were, then we can really push our way through here. We might even send in these forces here in which to do so. We won't do that though until we reassemble these forces here. These units will be going back into this fight. So all of these forces here will be pushing back into the fight here. Are we replenishing these? We are, so these gentlemen should be up to full strength pretty soon. But that is the fight. We're going to not give in. We're going to push through here once again. We only lost that battle because of time, believe me. The only reason we lost that is because of time. Otherwise, we would have won that battle. But still, look how many forces they've still got available to themselves here. They've still got 6,000 men left. And we've got, I believe we've got 7,000 men left. So we're not doing too bad here. But to crack this Venetian nut here, oh, who knows how many that's going to take here. But first of all, our goal is to take Hungary. If we can establish a foothold here, then we can move from there. We might even be able to feed in another force into here as well. Probably this force that's here. This army that's here is currently being replenished here. This is the force that we probably want to take into and really sort of re-establish our foothold here. We would actually take in a massive amount of their economy. Would be swept away from them here. We'd have a star fort as well, which would be fantastic. And we could have the pleasure guards. We get rid of this. They got two seminaries, which we don't need. These will be made immediately into economic hubs. But that's another fight, my friends, and I hope you've enjoyed this episode. If you have, please comment down below, my friends. Once again, your comments have been absolutely wonderful. They really, really have. Thank you for all your support. Please let me know what you think I should do. Should I now step back? Should we now step back from the Hungary expedition? Or should we replenish and then hit them again and again and again until we crack that first Austrian front, as it were, the Hungarian front, the first stepping stone into Austrian territory. But we know how hard it's going to be to actually break into their strategic depth, as it were. But my friends, hope you've enjoyed this. If you have, please comment, and please keep your comments coming down below. Again, they've been absolutely wonderful. Thank you so much for all your comments and all your support. Hope you're having a good week thus far, my friends. Whatever you're doing, please be safe and have a great time. But until next time, my friends, bye for now.